Election fever grips the entire country as the U.S. waits with bated breath for results from today's presidential vote. As people line up to vote, the candidates hit key battleground states in last-ditch efforts to turn out voters. Joe Biden will be traveling in his home state of Pennsylvania, seen as critical to winning the presidency. And President Trump yesterday made his closing arguments in Grand Rapids, Michigan, where he also rounded out the 2016 campaign. He is currently at the White House, but travels to Arlington, Virginia later on today. So we want to bring in CBS News political correspondent Ed O'Keefe, who is at Duffy Square in New York City. All right, Ed, both campaigns are still underway. How effective is this sort of last-minute campaigning, especially when we have, you know, a sort of unprecedented election that we're seeing where 100 million ballots have already been cast?
Well, good morning, Anne-Marie. Happy Election Day. It would not be a big day without talking to you, so I'm glad we got to do this before it really gets underway. The reason they seem to be deploying Biden back into Pennsylvania today is because of simple math. There's a belief that about 3 million and change votes have already been mailed in or requested or cast early, and potentially another 3 million and change that could be cast today. And remember, we've talked about this over the course of the last several months since the pandemic began. If Democrats were expected to show up and do it mostly beforehand, and Republicans were expected to do it mostly today, that could lead to a very close contest. So by sending Biden back into Pennsylvania today, you're trying to get him to potentially motivate just enough of the day of vote to vote in his favor and put him over the top in a state that he really wants to win. Remember, when he was a senator from neighboring Delaware, they kind of called him the third senator from Pennsylvania. He's from Scranton. He knows it well. And he's been convinced since this campaign began that he was the only Democrat uniquely qualified to win back places like Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, maybe Ohio, that Democrats lost 4 years ago.
And how will the candidates be spending their election night?
Well, the president will be at the White House for an event that we are told will include potentially up to 400 invited guests who have to be tested for coronavirus before they show up. There had been talk about a potential event at the Trump Hotel down the street there in Washington, but for now at least, that's been put off. Biden is holding an event in Wilmington, his hometown in Delaware, at the same site that they held the truncated, abbreviated, revamped Democratic convention in August. They'll use the same convention center and parking lot outside for a drive-in rally that will have at least 300 vehicles worth of supporters. The world's media is also there in that parking lot awaiting a possible set of remarks from him, if not late tonight, perhaps at some point in the wee hours of tomorrow. His campaign continues to insist there are no reasons to believe that President Trump can be declared the winner tonight for a few reasons. First of all, a winner isn't declared tonight by the states. It takes a while for that process to get sorted out and officially certified. It's usually that the media is able to project a winner or say, based on what we've seen so far and based on what we know is coming in, this person will win. But that doesn't make it official. It's the states that make it official. So nobody can really declare victory tonight. Secondly, they don't believe that he'll get to 270. So they're quite cautiously optimistic in the Biden camp, believing that it will be ultimately a successful night.
So talking to reporters a few days ago, the president said that as soon as the election is over, he's got lawyers standing by, or lawyers we're going to in with our lawyers. This is a quote. We're going in with our lawyers. What are some of the areas where we could potentially see litigation?
You'll see it around issues with balloting, with the ongoing counts of absentee ballots as they come in. It is likely in this situation it'll be places like Pennsylvania, possibly Michigan, Wisconsin, maybe Ohio, potentially Texas as well. There was a legal challenge tossed out by a federal district court yesterday that had been made by Republicans regarding the ongoing early vote in the Houston area, in Harris County there in Texas in the South. So, look, both sides have hundreds of lawyers ready. Doesn't mean they're all on the payroll. That would be a lot of money. But many of them are doing this pro bono, at least for now, and are literally prepared tonight, if need be, to go to the nearest courthouse and file motions to either stop counting, make sure that there's a sufficient paper trail, or respond to a lawsuit from the other side. They've been preparing for this for months. But again, there's a general belief, at least among Republicans, among Democrats, the GOP challenges to some of this will get blown off, and that they won't stand in court. And they've been making the point, look, if the Republican Party believes, if the president believes that the only way for him to win is to continue filing lawsuits, well, that's just not a way to claim victory.